10% of the Earth's land surface is covered in ice and looks like this. Greenland and Antarctica are covered by ice sheets that have been building up for millions of years, making them thicker than 3 kilometers and larger than the United States of America. They are two of the coldest places on Earth and home to unique species adapted to the cold, such as polar bears in Greenland and penguins in Antarctica. Ice sheets are glaciers on a continental scale, so they are formed if cold conditions enable snow to accumulate in places over decades, centuries and longer. Under the pressure of its own weight, the snowmass slowly compacts itself to form ice. Additional snow continuously falls onto the ice sheet. Year after year, a new layer is added to the ice. The NOM's pressure leads to thinner and thinner layers at the bottom of the glacier, which are eventually pushed out to the sides. If ice gains and losses are the same, the glacier is stable. Otherwise, it is either growing or shrinking. The gigantic ice masses in Greenland and Antarctica contain most of the fresh water on Earth, more than all the lakes combined. This makes the stability of the ice sheets very important for the global freshwater cycle as well as the oceans. Melting ice from the polar regions adds freshwater to the ocean, which leads to sea level rise and a change in the chemical composition of the ocean. The results are wildlife habitat losses and changes in ocean circulation, as well as devastating floods in cities near the ocean. The ice sheets at the poles also help to keep our Earth cool. Sunlight is easily reflected on the white surface that made up the snow. Dark rocks or the ocean, on the other hand, absorb the sunlight as heat. Without our ice sheet, the Earth would therefore be warmer than it is today, because more energy from the sun would be absorbed. We are therefore thankful for our ice sheets and wouldn't want to imagine Earth without them. I am part of the DEEPICE project because I enjoy researching the Earth's current and past climate.